President Barack Obama is calling on the nation's school children to take pride in their education and to stick with it, even if they don't like every class they have to take. President Obama offering up that message today in his first ever back to school address.
What's your contribution going to be? What problems are you going to solve? What discoveries will you make? What will a president who comes here in 20 or 50 or 100 years say about what all of you did for this country?
Plans for the speech initially sparked controversy as some GOP and school district officials worried that it would be too political a speech. And here in southern Maine, it's hard to gauge exactly how many students watched the president's speech today. An informal poll of school districts in the greater Portland area showed virtually all schools made it optional, leaving the decision up to students and teachers. Steve Minich joins us live in the newsroom now with local reaction to the president's message. Good evening, Steve.
Well, good evening, Tori. We talked to superintendents of both Westbrook and Auburn schools, and both certainly agree with the president's message. But getting kids to stay in school and take responsibility are subjects they already deal with daily.
What the president's speech does is brings it up front.
Westbrook Superintendent Reza Naaman believes just any talk of the president's speech has helped underscore the message that kids need to finish school.
Whether this speech was taking place or not, no, it wouldn't change anything.
There is no excuse for not trying.
While the president preached responsibility to the students,
I expect great things from each of you.
Naaman believes the school system has a responsibility, too, to identify as early as possible the kids that are losing interest, inviting them, in fact, to join his dropout committee.
Some of the students who are at the verge of dropout to be part of that committee, to listen to them, and the parents and staff about whether we have adequate programming, staffing, and do we address their needs.
The message is clear. It's an important message. It can't be told too many times.
Though the president targeted youngsters, Auburn superintendent says the message needs to be heard by everyone, that keeping kids in the classroom only begins with the student.
Whether it be the president or maybe a classroom teacher, or it's your parent at home, or it's a grandparent, the support behind it has to be there.
Support, Reza Naaman says, starts with the youngest of school students.
I believe pre-K to 12, you need to have a system where you know your child, you're addressing the child's emotional academic needs.
Before taking the job at Westbrook this year, Naaman was a superintendent in Massachusetts. He says during his tenure there, the dropout rate fell from more than 5% to less than 1%. In the newsroom, Steve Minich, News 8.